Every 57 seconds, a brand new car rolls off an assembly line somewhere in the world. Not a toy car, not a kit car, but a fully functional vehicle with over 30,000 individual parts assembled with precision measured in fractions of a millimeter. Right now, massive robotic arms are welding steel frames together with such force that sparks fly like fireworks in factories that never sleep. Paint booths are spraying thousands of layers of color so thin you could fit them all on a human hair. And workers with years of training are installing engines, wiring harnesses, and interiors with choreographed movements that look more like a ballet than manufacturing. The modern automobile assembly line is one of humanity's most impressive engineering achievements, where raw steel sheets enter one end and finished vehicles capable of traveling hundreds of thousands of miles exit the other. Today, we're taking you inside the car factory to show you exactly how these complex machines are built, from the first weld to the moment the wheels touch the ground for the very first time. This is the story of how cars are made. By the end of this video, you'll understand why it takes an entire factory working around the clock to build just a few hundred cars per day, why certain vehicles cost exponentially more than others despite looking similar, and exactly what happens during those crucial hours when raw materials transform into transportation. You'll see the five critical stages that every car passes through, and you'll never think about your vehicle the same way again. But before we head to the factory floor, if you're fascinated by how complex machines are actually built, hit that subscribe button right now, smash the like, and drop a comment telling us what vehicle or machine you want to see manufactured next. Let's get started. The assembly line revolutionized manufacturing forever, and it all started with cars. In 1913, Henry Ford introduced the moving assembly line at his Highland Park plant in Michigan, and the impact was immediate and staggering. Before this innovation, building a single Model T required 12 and a half hours of labor. After implementing the assembly line, that time dropped to just 93 minutes. The concept was brilliantly simple. Instead of workers moving to the car moved to the workers, with each person performing one specific task as the vehicle passed their station. This wasn't just faster, it was transformative for society. By dramatically reducing production time, Ford could lower prices, making cars affordable for average workers rather than just the wealthy elite. Within a few years, the Model T's price dropped from $850 to less than $300, and suddenly millions of Americans could afford personal transportation. Other industries immediately recognized the power of this system and adapted it to everything from appliances to electronics. But the automobile industry continued pushing assembly line technology further than anyone else. Today's car factories bear little resemblance to Ford's original innovation. Where his plant had workers manually bolting parts together, modern factories employ hundreds of sophisticated robots that can weld, paint, and assemble with superhuman speed and precision. Yet the core principle remains unchanged. The vehicle moves through sequential stations where specific operations happen in a carefully orchestrated order. This marriage of human craftsmanship and robotic precision is what makes modern automotive manufacturing so remarkable. The global automotive industry is genuinely massive in scale. Manufacturers produce approximately 80 million new vehicles annually, which means somewhere in the world, a new car is completed literally every second of every day. China leads global production with over 25 million vehicles per year, followed by the United States at around 11 million, and Japan at 9 million. These aren't small operations either. A typical automotive assembly plant covers over 3 million square feet, roughly equivalent to 55 football fields under one roof, and employs between 3 and 5,000 workers across multiple shifts. The supply chain supporting this production is equally impressive. A single vehicle contains components from hundreds of different suppliers spread across dozens of countries. The engine might be built in one country, the transmission in another, electronics from a third, and all of it converges at the final assembly plant with timing so precise that parts often arrive just hours before installation, a logistics strategy called just-in-time manufacturing that minimizes storage costs but requires flawless coordination. The economic impact is staggering. The automotive sector directly employs over 9 million people globally, but when you include suppliers, dealerships, and related industries, that number exceeds 50 million jobs. In the United States alone, one in every seven jobs is connected to the automotive industry in some way. And we're not just talking about cheap products either. The average new car sold today costs over $45,000 and contains more computing power than the spacecraft that landed astronauts on the moon. Modern vehicles have between 30 and 50 separate computers controlling everything from fuel injection to entertainment systems, processing more code than a modern fighter jet. This complexity is why automotive manufacturing has become such a sophisticated ballet of human skill and technological precision. The journey begins in the body shop, where the car's skeleton takes shape from flat sheets of steel and aluminum. This is one of the most automated areas of any factory, filled with massive robotic arms that move with surprising grace despite their size. The process starts with stamping, where enormous hydraulic presses exerting thousands of tons of force transform flat metal sheets into three-dimensional panels like doors, hoods, fenders, and roof sections. These stamping presses are so large that some weigh over 2,000 tons and require their own foundations separate from the building to prevent vibrations from affecting other operations. The noise is incredible, a thunderous boom every few seconds as metal is forced into shape. Each panel goes through multiple stamping operations, with progressive dies that gradually form the metal rather than trying to create the final shape in one violent impact. Once stamped, the panels move to the welding area, and this is where robots truly dominate. In a modern body shop, you might see 200 robots and only a handful of human workers. The robots work in coordinated teams, some holding panels in precise positions while others perform up to 5,000 individual welds per vehicle. The welding happens so fast it's hard for human eyes to follow, with robots completing spot welds in fractions of a second, moving to the next position, welding again, in a continuous dance that's been programmed down to the millimeter. But here's what most people don't realize. Those robots aren't welding randomly. Engineers have calculated the exact number, placement, and strength of welds needed to create a structure that's both light enough for fuel efficiency and strong enough to protect occupants in a crash. The floor pan gets welded together first, creating the foundation. Then side panels are added, followed by the roof, doors, hood, and trunk or liftgate. At this stage, the vehicle is just a bare metal shell, but it's already recognizable as a car. The completed body undergoes dimensional inspection using laser measuring systems that check hundreds of points to ensure everything aligns within tolerances typically less than 2 millimeters. If anything is out of spec, the entire body is pulled from the line for analysis to determine whether there's a problem with the stamping dies, the welding robots, or the fixtures holding everything in place during assembly. From the body shop, the bare metal shell moves to the paint shop, and this is where automotive manufacturing becomes almost pharmaceutical in its attention to contamination control. Paint shops are sealed, climate-controlled environments where even a single speck of dust can ruin a finish. The process begins with cleaning, where the body is completely submerged in chemical baths that remove oils, metal particles, and any other contaminants left from the welding process. Next comes the electrocoat primer dip, one of the most ingenious processes in automotive manufacturing. The entire body is submerged in a tank of electrically charged paint particles suspended in water. When voltage is applied, the paint particles are attracted to the metal surfaces, coating even the most hidden internal cavities and seams where corrosion typically starts. This electrocoat provides the foundation for corrosion resistance that allows modern cars to come with 10-year rust-through warranties. After electrocoating, the body passes through a massive oven where temperatures exceed 350 degrees Fahrenheit, baking the coating into a hard, protective layer. Then comes seam sealing, where robots apply beads of sealant to joints and seams to prevent water and air infiltration, followed by primer surfacer, another layer that fills tiny imperfections and provides a smooth base for color coats. Now the body is ready for actual color, and modern paint application is a technological marvel. Robotic arms with electrostatic paint guns apply multiple layers of base coat, with each layer being just a few micrometers thick. The electrostatic charge means paint particles are attracted to the metal surfaces, dramatically reducing overspray and waste. Four metallic colors, multiple coats create depth, with microscopic metal flakes suspended in the paint oriented by the application process to create that distinctive sparkle. After color comes clear coat, multiple layers of transparent urethane that provide gloss and UV protection. The entire painted body then goes through a final bake cycle at over 250 degrees, where the paint chemically crosslinks into a finish that's incredibly durable. The whole painting process takes about 8 hours and uses between 2 and 4 gallons of paint per vehicle, though modern processes reclaim and reuse most overspray, achieving efficiency rates above 90%. The painted body now moves to final assembly, the most labor-intensive part of the entire process and the area where human workers still dominate. This is where hundreds of components come together to transform a painted shell into a functioning vehicle. The process follows a carefully designed sequence that's been refined over decades. It typically starts with the installation of the wiring harness, a pre-assembled network of wires that connects every electrical component in the vehicle. Workers route these harnesses through channels in the body, securing them with clips and ties to prevent rattling or chafing. Next comes the dashboard assembly, which arrives as a complete module with the instrument cluster, airbags, climate controls, and infotainment system already installed. This entire assembly is lifted into place and secured with dozens of bolts. Seats arrive fully assembled from a supplier and are installed on tracks that allow adjustment. The headliner, that fabric covering the interior roof, is carefully positioned and clipped into place. Windows are installed with robotic precision, with adhesives that cure into structural bonds that actually contribute to body rigidity. Meanwhile, on the underbody, workers are installing the fuel tank, exhaust system, and suspension components. The engine and transmission arrive as a married unit, assembled elsewhere in the plant or shipped from a specialized engine factory, and the entire powertrain is lifted into the engine bay from below by a precise mechanical lift that positions it within millimeters before workers secure it with mounting bolts. The cooling system is connected, brake lines are routed and secured, the steering column is installed and connected to the steering rack. Wheels and tires, which were mounted and balanced earlier, are installed and torqued to exact specifications using automatic tools that measure and display the applied torque digitally. Exterior components like bumpers, mirrors, and lights are added. Every fastener, every electrical connection, and every fluid line is installed following a detailed work instruction, and many operations are verified electronically, with torque wrenches that record the exact torque applied to critical fasteners, ensuring nothing is over-tightened or left loose. The newly assembled vehicle isn't ready to ship yet. It must pass through a comprehensive quality control and testing process that verifies everything works as designed. The first station is the marriage point, where fluids are added. Engine oil, transmission fluid, coolant, brake fluid, windshield washer fluid, and fuel are all precisely measured and filled. Then comes the moment of truth, the first start. A technician turns the key or pushes the start button, and if everything has been assembled correctly, the engine fires to life for the very first time. This is actually a critical moment because any issues with the fuel system, ignition, or engine assembly will reveal themselves immediately. Assuming the engine starts properly, the vehicle moves to a rolling road dynamometer, where the car is secured on rollers and driven at various speeds while sensors monitor engine performance, transmission shifting, brake function, and emissions. Technicians are watching for any unusual noises, vibrations, or warning lights. Next comes a water test, where the vehicle is subjected to simulated rainstorm conditions with high-pressure water jets spraying from all angles to verify that all seals are properly installed and there are no leaks into the interior. A light test checks every single bulb and LED, from headlights to brake lights to interior illumination. The vehicle then goes through a detailed visual inspection where trained quality inspectors examine the paint finish under special lighting designed to reveal the tiniest imperfections like orange peel texture, dust nibs, or color inconsistencies. Panel gaps are measured with special gauges to ensure doors, hoods, and trunks align properly and open and close with the right feel. Finally, select vehicles are pulled for a road test, where professional drivers take them on a predetermined route that includes various road surfaces, turns, and speeds to verify real-world performance. Any issues discovered during quality control are addressed immediately. Minor problems like a loose trim piece or a warning light caused by an improperly seated electrical connector are fixed right there. More serious issues might require the vehicle to be pulled to a rework area for detailed diagnosis and repair. Only after passing all these tests and inspections is the vehicle approved for shipping. The entire assembly process from bare-painted body to finished vehicle ready for delivery takes between 18 and 30 hours depending on the complexity of the vehicle, and involves between 300 and 800 individual assembly operations performed by skilled workers and sophisticated automation working in perfect harmony. And there you have it, the complete journey of how a modern automobile goes from sheets of metal to a sophisticated machine capable of transporting you hundreds of thousands of miles. What looks like a simple purchase at a dealership represents the coordinated efforts of thousands of engineers, hundreds of suppliers, dozens of assembly line workers, and some of the most advanced manufacturing technology humans have ever created. The modern car contains more technology than most people realize. It's essentially a computer on wheels, with systems managing everything from fuel efficiency to collision avoidance, from entertainment to climate control. The fact that manufacturers can build these incredibly complex machines reliably, safely, and affordably is a testament to over a century of continuous refinement of the assembly line process that Henry Ford pioneered. Think about this. a modern assembly plant produces a vehicle every 60 seconds. That means in the time it took you to watch this video, over a dozen new cars have been completed somewhere in the world. It's mass production on a scale that's genuinely difficult to comprehend until you see it in person. Before you go, I want to hear from you. Now that you've seen how cars are built, what other vehicle or machine manufacturing process should we explore? Should we go inside a motorcycle factory? See how electric vehicles are different from traditional cars. Watch how massive trucks or buses are assembled. Drop your ideas in the comments below because we read every suggestion and your input directly influences what we cover next. And if this look inside automotive manufacturing fascinated you, here's what I need you to do. Hit that subscribe button right now so you never miss an episode. We're going inside factories and showing you how the products that shape modern life are actually made. Give this video a like if you learned something new today because it helps us reach more people who are curious about how things work. Share this with anyone who loves cars, or anyone who's ever wondered what actually happens at those massive factories you see from a highway. Sometimes understanding how something is made helps you appreciate it even more. Thanks for watching, and remember, the next time you drive your car, you'll know exactly what went into building it and why quality manufacturing matters. Until next time, stay curious, keep questioning how things work, and we'll see you in the next one.